ladies.
Hello.
First win of the season, all thanks to Coach Javi's amazing tactical training.
Yes.
Any thoughts on this?
Ina.
And thanks to Ina for filming. Appreciate it.
It was rough. It was rough, but we got through it and we won, and that's what counts.
Aren't you all starting to get tired of Javi's face?
Nobody gets tired.
Bye.
Bye.
Peace. You want to say bye, Ina? How's it going, guys? Coach Javi here, and we're gonna start a new series today. Let me know what your thoughts are on this, but as part of the series, I wanna break down some game footage and do some player breakdowns, some tactical breakdowns, and just show you guys how I analyze some of the film from our games, what I'm looking for, because I know a lot of you guys have asked me what I look for in specific positions or what coaches look for in specific positions. So using the film of our game, I figured we could break that down, and we could break down individual player performances. So we'll call this new series Tactics Corner with Coach Javi. I also want to get Bradley involved, so we might do some videos with Bradley Morrison. He is basically just in charge of the first team of our men's side here, so he can do a really, really advanced tactics corner on the men's side. I'm going to do the women's side and some of the reserve matches as well. So for the first video, we're going to break down one of our player performances. So it's going to be a little player breakdown. We're going to look specifically at our number 8, or our center mid. She played very, very well this game, and I figured I would break down her performance for you guys and show you kind of why she had a good performance, what she did exactly, and how that helped us. So this is the player we're going to be working with. She's our number 8, so she plays in that central midfield position, which means we really need her to dictate play, right? We want to play, if we want to build out of the back, or if we want to play and get to the attacking third, she's going to play a big part in that. So check out her movements, check out how she gets into spaces, how she gets into passing lanes, and what her decisions are on the ball. So we don't have the ball right now, so we're in our defensive shape. Watch as she moves in relation to the ball. Always checking her surroundings. When we do win the ball back, she immediately becomes an option. So she checks in, she receives the ball, and she plays a simple pass. After that, she moves into a different space, is able to receive the ball again, has a little space to dribble forward, so she dribbles forward, realizes she can't go forward, she drops the ball back, and then we're slowly creeping up the field. Now watch, as she gets away to create a little bit more space between her and the other center mid. That way the other center mid can dribble a little bit. As she gets into a different space, she receives it, and now we're a little bit higher up the field. Our winger recognizes it, and she can play it out wide to our winger. But watch again as our number 8 drops into that space, creates a passing angle so that she can receive the ball back just in case our winger decides she doesn't have anybody to play to. Which is exactly what happens. She plays her back. She tries to play a ball in. It's a little bit of a forced ball that high up the field, but we're starting to creep up, and the higher up we get, the more chances we have to take to be able to go in and create a goal scoring opportunity. So we're in defensive shape. She cuts off the pass. As our other center mid gets the ball, we have two of our center mids higher up. So she decides to stay back, guard the space. In case we lose the ball, she'll be able to help us recover it. Again, she's popping into this space. And if you look, the other team hasn't set their lines properly. And so there's lots of space in the midfield. So she stays in that huge gap. She's able to creep up the field with us. She's able to recover the ball. And again, plays it out wide for a 1v1 situation with our winger. She stays in that passing lane. She comes back to help defend. Just chasing after the girl puts a little bit of pressure on her to release the ball. As she's recovering, I want you to pay attention to her run. So she starts tracking back. She starts tracking back, but if you look, she checks her shoulder, sees where the opposition player is, and she stands right next to her. In case the opposition player decides to bring the ball back and try and pass it to the girl that's in the middle, she can cut that pass off. We end up winning the ball, and instead of her trying to check too close to the ball and cutting off that space for one of our defenders, she stays in that pocket, right? She stays in that pocket. We play the ball out wide, and now it creates a passing lane for her to receive. Very, very important. As this ball is passed, look at her check her shoulder. She checks her shoulder, sees that there's no defenders there, and she turns, she keeps dribbling, finds a pass forward. Once she finds that pass forward, instead of continuing to go forward, she drops off a few steps to be a passing option once again, receives the ball, and then she helps us switch play. The player one touches it back, and now we can switch it to the other side. So very, very simple, just getting into the gaps, checking her shoulder, driving forward, allowing us to get up the field. Now she stays in that middle pocket. As the ball gets shifted back over, she becomes an option again. She receives it. She drives forward a little bit, takes a little bit of her space, tries to play a 1-2, pass gets cut off, but then she makes the tackle to try and recover the ball. Now watch her movement again. She's tracking back, and look at her take that midfield position. Again, she stays in that little pocket. She stays in that little pocket when we're trying to play forward, but she's become an option. so that when we try and swing the ball back over, again, she stays in that middle, she becomes an option, is able to drive forward. Now watch her body shape as she receives this ball. When she receives it with the farthest foot, she opens up her hips, and she takes her touch forward. That way, she doesn't have to take the time to turn, but she's already facing in the direction that she wants to play. Now we end up taking a shot that goes to the keeper, but again, now with those little movements of her getting into those little pockets of space, being able to play quickly, being able to play simple, she allows us to get an opportunity in the attacking third. So the last clip I'm gonna show you here, we play back to the keeper. We're gonna try and build out because they're not pressuring us. Everybody starts getting into their positions. Watch as our player here gets into these little pockets. She realizes she's not involved, but she's hanging out in those little spaces. Now as we move the ball a little bit, if the space doesn't close, she stays. She stays. Now as our goalkeeper gets this ball, she realizes that she can become an option. She checks her shoulder to see if there's any defenders on her, and then she checks into that little pocket of space. Our goalkeeper can play her. Now she can turn, face forward, and play a pass directly into our winger. That little smart movement to get into that pocket of space again helps us build out. So those are just a few quick clips. Very, very happy with her performance in this game. I think she did a great job of just keeping it simple, finding those pockets of space, being able to help us in the build-up, and being able to help us create chances to score. So some of the things I want to emphasize real quick before we end the video is her scanning the field and checking her shoulder. In all those clips, she was always checking her shoulder, scanning the field, so that when she received the ball, she could see whether she could turn or whether she might have to just play a simple ball back, right? Another thing is she stayed in those pockets of space until it got closed down. If the pocket of space was closed down, she immediately dropped off or moved forward into a different pocket of space. And then the last thing was she always made herself available. So when the other players had the ball, she was always trying to find an open passing lane, becoming an option, whether it was dropping off a few steps or whether it was getting into a completely different space, she always became a passing option. And that's very, very important for center mids. One of the biggest things about center mids is they always have to be available. If you're gonna wanna play and build out and try and keep the ball, the majority of the time, the ball is gonna have to go through your center mid. If you wanna switch the point of attack, if you wanna switch the play, if you wanna penetrate forward, usually, your center mids are gonna be a very, very important asset to the team. So if you guys like the video, make sure you go ahead and hit that like button. I'm gonna continue to do these as the season goes on with different games, whether it's our women's game or our reserves game. And of course, I'll get Bradley to do the first team games. I'll try and cover a bunch of different positions. So as the season goes on, we have different player breakdowns, different positions, and you guys can take all of these points that I talked about and implement them in your game. So quick reminder though, guys, when we hit 30,000 subscribers, I'm gonna do a Q&A with Stina, and I've decided to do a Q&A with Keely as well, my goalkeeper, because I get a lot of goalkeeper questions and I don't wanna alienate the goalkeeper position. So I figured as soon as we hit 30,000, I'll do a Q&A with Stina and with Keely. So you can get the perspective of an American goalkeeper, Division I athlete, and an international center mid from Norway. So ask any type of question you want about absolutely anything soccer related, being a college athlete. I'll make an Instagram post where you can go down there and you can comment all of your questions. So if you're not following me on Instagram, go ahead and follow me right now. So if you go to my Instagram right now, there is a post where you can go and comment down all of your questions. Absolutely every question you have for these players, I'll have the players answer as many of those questions as they can. So again, hope you guys liked the video, and I'll see you guys on the next one.